Women and Latinos, Hispanics, and young skulls full of mush all came in big for Obama, and his policies are crushing them, particularly in terms of unemployment. But it didn't matter. Obama's female unemployment, all-time high in this country. But they're going to get their birth control pills. Who would have ever believed? You know, so Tucker Carlson last night on Fox, he was talking about radio ads Obama was running in Pennsylvania, all on abortion. Single women in this country were actually moved to vote for Obama because they thought Romney is going to take abortion away from them. They're actually made to believe that. Romney couldn't. There's no president who can. That doesn't matter. I got to take the chance. The truth and reality and the Constitution doesn't matter. Stunning. You have Obama's policies are crushing women, young people. Look at student loan debt. Look at the lack of jobs. Look at the cost of college tuition. Obama's making everything worse. These people showed up in droves. Why? Ditto Hispanics and their unemployment. And he didn't even come through for them on immigration. And they still showed up. Why? Women voted Obama 55 to 43 for Romney. Massive gender gap. Unchanged from 2008. Unmarried women backed Obama 68% to 30%. They thought Romney was going to take away their birth control pills. Obama treats them like vaginas, and they say, he's my man. Go figure. Obama won the Ute vote, 24-point margin. Overall turnout of young voters was up over 2008. Even the Democrats thought it was going to be down. 71% Latino vote for Obama. That's the worst any Republican has gotten since modern polling began, and it's a growing Democrat. 71% of Latino votes. So what are we to do? Do we come out for amnesty and illegal immigration now? Is that how we get them? I'm asking. I'm not being rhetorical. Do we start passing out birth control pills? I'm asking, not rhetorically. This is what it said the Democrats are doing to get their votes. So what do we do? People who think this way and vote this way outnumber us now, folks. And we are losing ground. And we have a political party that's more than happy to capitalize on this. However you want to characterize these people, their lack of knowledge, their fear, their susceptibility to being victim, whatever you want to say, the Democrat Party is more than willing to destroy the traditions and institutions that have defined this nation's greatness. Doesn't matter what it takes. Doesn't matter what they end up doing to people's lives. Because at the end of it, they're all going to have a phone, a TV set, a car, and 120 free minutes and food stamps. No matter how bad it gets, they're going to be able to watch TV and eat and get around and text their buddies. It used to be when you were unemployed, that stuff came to screeching halt, including eating. Santa Claus or that. And then your point is at the same time we're doing that, we're asking them to throw away Santa Claus.